everybody. Elena Yee here, PC World with...
Adam Patrick Murray.
Yay!
Hello.
So, Nintendo is re-releasing the NES Classic today. I believe we're posting this video on Friday the 29th.
Well, and actually, I'll tell you the truth, I forgot that they were re-releasing it.
And then you told me, and I was like,
oh yeah, money, money, money.
Right. But if you're more of the DIY type, or I'd rather just have all the games on a single system type person, then by this point, you've already built a RetroPie like we did last fall.
Like we did, right here.
Yeah.
Based off of a nice Super Nintendo shell.
So cute.
Yeah, loved it.
So in honor of NES Classic Re-Release Day, we thought we would actually move your RetroPie into a theme-appropriate case.
Yeah, why not?
Just for funsies.
I mean, that's the great thing, is that when you build your own and you have everything on here, you can put whatever case you want. So, you know, if I like feel like SNES, I do that.
It's like changing an outfit.
Yeah, perfect. So, and then I got this sent to me by NESPY case. They sent this to me, and it's actually a pretty nice little guy. I've been meaning to throw my RetroPie into this, and now is the perfect time to do it. So why don't we just dig right in? You want to open up the box?
I love this box, though.
The box is awesome, and actually, I have looked at inside the box already, so it's not like this is a true unboxing or anything.
So speaking of boxes and loving boxes, and perhaps becoming the next episode of Hoarders, I have a bad habit of like saving packaging. So every single time I go somewhere like Japan, where all the packaging is beautiful, I just basically collect garbage.
Well, this is a nice box. I mean,
it
literally has everything. It looks just like the rest of the case. Ports and all.
It even has that yellowed kind of thing going on.
Yeah, the box isn't too yellowed, but they got.
No, but look, see, the box is a nice color, but this has that like softer,
gray.
That gray that's kind of turning a little bit. That's great.
Yeah, it's nice.
Size, huh?
So it's got some extra functionality that the Super Nintendo one didn't. This actually has buttons.
Buttons that work.
Buttons that work. Reset, power, LED. The flap opens to reveal extra ports. Though I don't like the Ethernet being up front, because that's whatever. That's more of a limitation of Raspberry Pi, I think. You know, we got the SD card slot, got HDMI, power. Whichever version of power you want. And then they even have this little thing at the bottom that is for extra SD cards. It's like a little, if you can kind of see in there.
I'm gonna make all the squealing noises.
Yeah, so, you know.
I love that.
It's a nice little case, I tell you what.
That's super clever.
So why don't we start, you got the tools there if you wanna pull that guy out.
Oh man, I'm so disappointed now, even more so that these buttons don't work on the SNES case.
Yeah, I've seen ones that do. And then the kit, if you remember from the build, I accidentally didn't get the kit with the light.
Oh yeah.
So it didn't light up, but if you want to take it apart right here. And yeah, there's a little bit of an instruction manual on this guy. I feel like we're doing a mini build all over again.
Oh, these are intense screws. Look how deep those go.
Hey, you know what? We're not messing around here. We want a Raspberry Pi case that's gonna keep it protected, right? don't want to be dropping it. Actually, so I'll also say while we're doing this, after I had built this, I did end up finding an SNES Classic. I don't know if you remember me talking to you about it, but you know, I found one. I ended up buying it. I played it, and I mean, sure, it's nice. It's got a nice build quality to it. It's got really nice software.
The UI is really great on it, actually.
It really is. But after a while of playing it, I was like, man, I already have something that I can play other games on as well. You know, and sure, it's not as nice, but I felt really limited, especially after building my own. So, you know, to each their own. I'm glad I got it, but if I were to do it again, I probably wouldn't buy it.
We're gonna have to disconnect the fan.
Yeah, it looks like on the instructions here. Oh, and this is. Ooh! Careful.
It's too late. I've made a commitment. I've removed it.
Awesome.
Oh, little tiny screws connecting that to the board. I have a bad habit of talking to inanimate objects like they're people.
Man, I totally forgot about these cute little heat sinks.
They are the most adorable. Okay, that's a
seat. I tell you what, though, this thing does get hot. Like, I've picked it up after hours of playing on it, and I'm like, wow, okay, this is surprisingly warm.
It's
so
warm.
I'm glad I got the heat sink.
I also want to comment, I think it's hilarious that every time we do a build, it's usually me that ends up doing the manual labor.
I mean, I can do it if you want me to.
No, you've
got the fine motor control, you know? It really helps in situations like these.
I still marvel every time, like, how small these boards really are. I guess I should have taken out the SD card, but I'll do that just in case.
Yeah, sure.
Just for safety.
Yeah.
It's just so tiny.
I know. It's fun. It's already seen some good use. Mm-hmm. I like it. So if we look inside this case, I gave just a little bit of a peek when we open it up. It has a nice little kit already laid out with the screws for the case.
Give you the screwdriver. That's nice of them.
A little screwdriver. So, look, we have the extension for the Ethernet, obviously coming to this plug, which, once again, I actually kind of wish it was around back, but whatever.
This case is a lot more complex.
Because of that, that's obviously where the SD card goes. It slots in like this.
All right, so this goes into there on that side.
Like all the way at the end?
Yes, which explains why it's positioned over here.
Okay. Does it go like this, or is it backwards?
Whatever side doesn't... Oh my goodness, I'm going to just break all your things. All right, so this one, see how it doesn't have a pin at the very top?
Oh, okay.
That's the side that aligns with the far edge.
Got it.
Make sense?
Okay.
So it goes in, I believe, goes in like that.
Should we do that first, or should we put the board secured in?
Let's see how much play you'll get. I think it'll be okay to put the board in first.
Okay, yeah, let's do it. Let's secure the board into the thing with the cute little screwdriver.
Well, you give it a try.
Let's do it.
All right, here is your little screwdriver, sir.
So let me... Okay. So let me put this on real quick. Because the first step was this guy. All right, that's done. Second step.
Oh, look, I should have just read the instructions.
Instructions.
So we use the black ones here to secure alongside the pins. So the black ones go right there and right there.
Nope, there we go.
This one, I'm not sure if you actually...
Does it go into one specific?
It looks like it might be specific. Yeah, it seems to highlight this. I'm not sure if it's really that specific, but you may as well.
Okay, cool. All right. So,
Wait, these two? One here.
Oh, okay. Got it.
So what happens when you read the manual? You actually figure
Perfect.
Stuff out.
Yeah, take note, Gordon. All right. I tell you what, that's a nice little package, right? Everything's kind of tucked away.
It's very tidy.
All right, we put the top on and the wrist.
Wait, let me just check to make sure I can insert the SD card from the outside. Otherwise, we may have to redo this whole thing.
Oh, yes. Good call.
Sorry about that. Let's see. Connectors. I did it.
Oh.
I did it, Mom.
Yeah. There we go. Yeah. And there's just enough of a little lip to grab it if you need
Which
to.
Which makes sense, because if you're going to be swapping cards, then it makes
Boom.
It easy.
Alright, so far so good. Oh, you know what? I'm sorry, I got the name of the company wrong. The name of the company is RetroFlag. It says right here, RetroFlag.com. The name of this case is Nest Pi Case. Okay, whoops, sorry about that. So the NES re-release that they're doing, is there anything different? Have you heard?
I didn't think so.
Yeah,
I only
think
looked
it's literally
into it.
Just they're manufacturing more,
I think
right?
they're just manufacturing more because it sold out so quickly during that first run in, what is it, fall 2016?
Yeah, and I feel like the SNES one Can I have the last one? I feel like the SNES actually stayed in stock pretty well. Like I didn't hear too many people like freaking out like they couldn't get one. It took some time.
I think they ramped up production.
But, yeah.
And then it's also it's $20 more expensive. So I wonder if that also put some people off.
Yeah, but it's got Star Fox 2.
I'm just saying.
Come on.
Would you pay $20 for Star Fox 2?
Sure. Why not?
You did.
I did. Yeah.
I did too.
But also I loaded it on my RetroPie, so. Yeah, there it is. Boom.
Oh no, what happened here?
I had a little bit of a
smudge.
Yeah, a little bit of smudge on it. So yeah, here's the NES Pi Case Plus, but from RetroFlag. It looks like For All of Us is their logo. So you got the nice little ports here. The only downside is the Ethernet. I wish the Ethernet was out of the back. But hey, I mean, you got the HDMI, power, USB, you know, and then the little extra card slot. I'm digging it. And I do know, I mean, we're not going to do it here, but I do know the light does power up. And it is a traditional one click for power and then a soft
so
reset.
Good.
So
good.
Yeah, there it is. I've done it.
So cute.
So yeah, I want to compare the size of this. We should compare the size of this to the actual NES Classic.
Oh, I should have brought mine in.
Yeah, whatever. It's fine.
I didn't think about that.
It's pretty close, but let me see the old one. Yeah, it's definitely, you know, to each his own and the style one, but this one definitely comes with some nice features, so I'm happy about it. So anyway, there we go. You know, we updated our retro Pi build just a little bit to celebrate the NES Mini Classic, whatever it's called, rebirthing into this world.
Happy re-release day.
Yeah, so we'll see everybody later for more retro gaming content on PCWorld.com.
It's so cute. I just want to take you home with me.